Hello, I'm Dr. Joe once again on our Health and Sanity calls. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a professional speaker helping busy people stay healthy, sane, and productive. And so I started these calls mainly to help people figure out what they can do. If you watch the news, you're on social media, you're being told all the things that you can't do. And it's going to be really stressful unless you can balance it out with some things that you can do. So every one of my calls, I've been focusing on this one thing that we can do to stay healthy and sane during these difficult times. And today I have with me my friend Neely. And this all started probably about a week ago when I called her pretty early in the morning, and she's 1 hour earlier than me. She's in Dallas, I'm in Florida. And she and I have been pals for like the last 10 years. We call each other at all hours of the day. And hey, I got this brilliant idea. What do you think about this? And just always brainstorming and unloading and whatever else. So I called her pretty early in the morning and she said, hi, how are you? Now this is the first week of being shut in the house, limiting what I can do. I can't go to the pool or the park, and the beaches were even closed. Frankly, I was feeling a little down about all that. And here's this woman like, hey, what you doing? And I said, Neely, how can you be so positive? And she said, what do you mean? I'm always this way first thing in the morning because I have a morning ritual. And I said, well, I have a morning ritual too, but it involves getting up, making breakfast, watching the news while I eat breakfast, not the news on TV. Mine's on, you know, looking at the news on my phone. I refuse to watch the news. That's been stressful for me, so I read it. And then I go for, you know, walk, run, bike, or whatever I do. But Neely has this morning routine that is way healthier, especially now. And so she wrote an article for her followers, and I'll share with you in the newsletter as well, on self-care. And she's going to touch on a few aspects of these. But first of all, let me tell you a little bit about Neely. Her last name is Neely. First name is Jennifer, but she doesn't go by Jennifer. And I, in fact, when I met her, she told me she was Neely. And I said, I can't call you Neely. But guess what? I'm calling her Neely now. So anyway, she, like me, as a registered dietitian nutritionist, when I met her, she was still at Cooper Clinic, but she has a lot of clinical background, although this is her second career. She was in sales for many, many years, but now she has her own business. She's a certified well coach. Is that how you say it, Neely? Is it well coach, certified coach? Or
certified wellness coach, yeah.
Certified wellness, but it's Well Coach, isn't it?
Well Coach is the school that I went to.
Okay, all right. So she works one-on-one with people, kind of like we would be her ideal audience, if that gives you some idea, as in her and I. And and I think probably most importantly, especially because we might have an interruption, not from a little one like my little one. I told you I'm babysitting for my 2.5-year-old granddaughter at times. She's not here right now. But so her mom can keep her job because everybody's home. But Neely has, do you have two gentle giants here today or just one?
And they're being quiet right now.
So. Yeah, so she has been a foster mom to 49 Great Danes.
George is my 49th, yes.
Yeah, so Lex is hers, and they do, what do you call it, the therapy?
He's a certified therapy, so we go to like, well, not now, but nursing homes and things like that, so it's been like almost 4 years, and we just like make people smile, so.
Yes, and Lex also is a video star.
He is. He's got Great Danes Dish is his YouTube channel.
Great Danes Dish. And what she does is she has a message about health and wellness, but she somehow makes it so it's coming out of Lex's mouth, but it's not even her voice. You kind of pitch it up somehow with some software, right?
Yeah.
He sounds like a professor. Don't you think? Professor Lex.
It's so funny. Yeah.
Yeah. So Lex gives his advice. So anyway, Neely, would you share with us your morning ritual, what it involves, because I think we all need a healthier, saner morning ritual to set us up for a more positive day.
Yeah. So I probably started this, it had to be over 30 years ago. And it started, you know, like all habits, they start, I think all behavior that stays with us, I think just, you know, happens by doing it small. And so what I just started doing was taking some quiet time in the morning. And so I just like what I do now, because I don't have to be anywhere. I work from home. Mostly I don't have to be anywhere. As I make my cup of coffee, and then I have a chair. It's a big chair. It's a chair and a half that both Lex and I sit in. And I just sit there and drink my coffee. And there's a couple of things that I do. It started by reading a 24-hour a day book. I mean, when I started it, but it's kind of evolved over time. But, you know, people might think of it like as meditation or I don't know, but you know, to me, I think that's all kind of sounds like kind of woo-woo-y, but this is just my quiet time. It's my me time. And what it does is it helps center me and put me in the right frame of mind for the day. I'll talk about, sometimes I write and I'll talk about that in a moment, but what works for me is reading something. And the book that I have now it's called Jesus Calling. And you can see it's very, very well worn. It was actually given to me by Cindy Kleckner, another dietitian, in November of 2012. And it's just like a day by day, every single day, it's got its own message. And then it has some scripture, a few scriptures. And I didn't start reading the scriptures until just about a couple of years ago, but this is the one I currently have. And so I read the message for the day, and I have to read it multiple times because my head is just like all over the place. So I just, you know, try to quiet my mind and I read it. And then I read, and then in a Bible, I look up those passages. This is just the New International Version of the Bible. And I look at those, but there's like two or three of the passages, and they're just, you know, like one or two verses. And so I read those. And then during this time, I have this, this is my soothing stone. This is my serenity stone, whatever. It's my self-care stone, whatever you want to call it, but I just hold on to it. And it's kind of like a symbol for me just to slow down. So this is the one that I got. This is actually a stone from New Zealand, the shores of New Zealand. And before I had this one, I actually had a crystal. I should have brought it in, but it's in my car right now. So I have a crystal and it fits in my hand perfectly. Got it in Sedona, Arizona. And I keep that one in my car. And when traffic kind of gets the better of me, or I just need to quiet my mind because I'm a little bit stressed and maybe run in a couple minutes late, I'll just pick it up. And just, it's just like that symbol that just calms me down. And it reminds me to take some deep breaths and just to focus and get in the here and now. So that one I keep in the car, but it's just, you know, you might call it a talisman or, you know, whatever you want to call it. It can be anything, but it's just something that I use as a symbol to remind me to take some deep breaths. And so that's really, you know, what I do and I usually sit for, now, because I do work from home, I'll usually sit for, you know, 45, 60 minutes. Sometimes I read. Where before, when I was working, I would take a shower, then I would sit for a period of time, and depending on how much time I had. But no matter how much time or how little time, I always do it. And it's just become my habit, my ritual. And it just, and sometimes, like, you'll call me in the morning and I won't answer because, you know, I'm taking my quiet time. So, and or I'll message you back saying, you know, call you back a little bit later. But yeah, that's so that's what I do, and it works best for me first thing in the morning. I have a client of mine. She calls she's got her daily devotion. You know, there's daily devotions that you can read, and I was actually looking for some things that I've had over the years. So this is another 24-hour book. This is 24 hours a day. It's I don't have keep it a secret that I'm a recovering alcoholic. So that for over 30 years. But anyway, so this is one I got probably through through the program. Then I had this one. This is Nightlight. So if people like to just breathe something at night, and just like they're just daily, you know, daily sayings. And then another one I had was Daily Prayers for Busy People. So there's a lot of these type of books that...
And I should interject also, Neely, that it doesn't have to be religious based for those people. Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of meditation books. It's just about, you know, empowering you to be strong or have patience or have grace.
Yeah, I'm not a religious person. I'm a spiritual person. But I'm, you know, I don't think that, you know, I'm very religious, but I have found, because I didn't read the Bible verses in the meditation book I have now until just a couple years ago. So it's just kind of how things have evolved for me. But so just quieting the mind first thing in the morning. And then something else I do, if needed, is I call it the power.
Wait, before that one, you do have one other thing that you do all the time. You have a big jar.
Well, I haven't gotten there yet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But if needed, and I call it the power of the pen. And that is, it's, you can call it a diary, a journal. And I do not write it in every day. This is the one I'm writing in now. And I actually started this one, of course, appropriately. It's just blank pages. And I picked these up at, you know, $5-6 at, you know, Tuesday morning or TJ Maxx, and if needed. And when I say if needed, when it's needed for me is when stuff is just like up here in my head. It just, something is bugging me. And I call it my itty bitty shitty committee. You know, it's like, it's just like up there, and it's like, it just, it stays there until I write about it. And so I just write whatever it is that's on my mind, and sometimes it's just half a page and sometimes it's several pages, but whatever it is, and it always, 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 you know, helps me. And so it's writing, and it's just, there's something about just getting it out of your head, you know. I think, and I say it, you know, it's the difference between comfort and contentment and discomfort and discontentment, but you know, it takes practice, but I think it's very healing. And I encourage all of my clients to do that, especially if they've got, and you can do it at night. I do it in the morning. It's just when my habit is. So that's something else I do. And I, you know, some people say, well, what do I write about? And sometimes, you know, what I'll encourage people to do, it's like, you might just write, like, maybe it's your boss or, you know, a coworker, somebody is just like living up there. Writing a letter to them, you know, and, or maybe it's, you know, your mother or, you know, your spouse. And it can be, I actually had written, I think this is just an example of what, you know, it's like, dear significant other, I know you love me, but why must you insist on sabotaging my efforts to live a healthful life? I'm trying my best to make good choices. So sometimes, you know, our spouse, when people are trying to be their best, they just sabotage them. So I just, you know, write a letter to them. I've got a wonderful relationship with my mom. So, but I know that others don't have that great relationship. So, but I know that, you know, it can inhibit somebody from being their best. So just writing about it, I think, is very helpful. So I first started writing just in like, on what do you call those, legal pads. And then I kind of evolved to the nice little journal. So yeah. And sometimes they last me, I think I started writing in this one in November 2015. Wow. So it's not, but yet I've had other ones that I've gone through like within a year, because it just kind of depends on how much drama is in my life.
Now, let me ask you a question, Neely. Do you save those journals?
I do, but see, I live alone. And so, and if I did live with somebody, or if I was married, I would, you know, I would, because it's just really kind of cool to have them. But you don't, I mean, if somebody would feel better about just writing it out and then, you know, shredding it or something, you know, yeah. But for me, I actually have them. So I can actually look past them. They're somewhere. I've got the first, the couple of them, the last maybe 10 years in one place, but
yeah. No, I will journal as well, only when I'm going through difficult times, like you, not on an everyday basis. And so I might, and I use those steno pads that are spiraled at the top because you can flip them over. I hate when something, you know, like some of those journal books, it's, you have to crack them open in order to write on. I can't handle that. And then I don't like writing on both sides of the page. That really bothers me. So I just write. And then when I get past that difficult stage and I feel like I'm healed from it, then I like to do a bonfire and throw it all in there. So I am married. My husband's here. He knows. I can't imagine he would ever crack open any of my journals.
I think that this isn't going to be any, you know, Academy Award winning thing in my school. So who would play me anyway, you know? I have to say, so I do get one that but I only write on one side.
You too.
But when I get to the end, I flip it over, and then my hand is, because it's hard to write. So here is, like, you know, upside down. So I can think, oh, that was when was that? That was December 2015. You know, so, but yeah. So I only write on one side, and then I flip it over. So that
Neely,
way.
Am I in your book?
I showed you that. Yes.
What?
One of my old books, and I'm like, it just happened to open up to this page, and it's like, and I
it was the day that we met, right?
Well, we were staying together at one of our annual conferences in Denver, and we had rented Airbnb's VRBO, you know, with Wendy Jo Peterson and some other people were in the house, and you.
Well, you were all the board members, and I wasn't on the board, remember?
Right. You needed a place. The last couple of nights, and it's like, oh my god, I saw Joe in her flannels.
I know, we sat in bed in our PJs and chatted. Yeah, so you weren't complaining about me, you were just saying
no.
That was kind of cool that you sent me a snapshot of that page.
Like, yeah, so it's that's kind of how our relationship started, you know. That was like, yeah, you know, years ago, and you know, it's
it started in bed. But I know you have to clarify all that. It sounds kind of bad.
Yeah. No, it's just, yeah. So it was, yeah, we were roomies. So it was pretty cool. Yeah. So, mm-hmm. And we've become just great colleagues and great. So, yeah. So
now you have one other thing that you do in the morning.
I do. And the other thing is my happiness jar. And I actually have my happiness jar. This is what it looks like. So now there's a significant, and I got this for like 10 bucks at, you know, Tuesday morning. And there's a significance to this. Can you see the lid? It's got a, what is
that?
And what's this up here?
Another bird?
Another bird. So Bird is my nickname from my brother. I'm Jay Bird. So my nephew calls me Aunt Bird. Isn't that charming? Yeah. Anyway, so there's a significance. But what I do, and this is this year's, I started several years ago, but I have these little colorful little pieces of paper. And every morning when I, after I take my quiet time, I write on a little slip of paper, and I'll write, you know, for the day before. So today is the 27th, March 26th, what made me happy? Working in my office with the office doors open to the sunshine. That's what made me happy. So, I mean, so I just, no matter how bad things might get, there's always something, you know, that would make me. So, and then I just put in my little jar, and then at the end of the year, the beginning of the following year, I just, you know, read them. So, together.
You actually, I've actually seen you on Facebook Live, and you're pulling them out and reading them, and some of them are like,
ah. I know, like, oh my god, what, she had a good poop? Oh yeah, and that's all that made me happy, really.
That's exactly the one I was thinking about.
I know. It's like, you know, hey, it's the little things in life, you know, you gotta find the lemonade and the lemon. So anyway,
yeah, but, there you go.
It's the quiet time, it's, you know, using a journal, the power of the pen, and then, you know, having happiness jar. And I know that some people use, like, they'll have like a gratitude journal, or, you know, something, or at the end of the day, they'll write, you know, what they're grateful for. But I just started the happiness. I read about it somewhere and I just started that. So that's been mine.
I know. And Neely, also for people that you mentioned early on that you start little. So here you've got this whole idea, but it takes an hour, and people think, I don't have an hour, you know. Let's talk about those tiny habits, shall we?
I mean, it can be just, you know, somebody might want to start doing something, and it's like, if they think, it's just like exercising. Oh my gosh, I don't have time to exercise for an hour. 5 minutes, you know, or it can be like 2 minutes. Just make a commitment to, I'm going to sit down. First of all, find a place, you know, find a comfortable place that you can, you know, that's your place. Right now it's the big chair in my office where, you know, this chair used to be in my living room. So it used to be there, but, and before I switched my rooms around, this used to be where my bed used to be. And I used to sit here and look outside. So just find a place. So that's the first thing. And then, just make a commitment that you're going to, you know, just for 1 minute or 2 minutes or five, just sit there, do nothing, just sit there to get in the habit of doing it. And then, you know, if you want it, you know, maybe you want to pick up a journal and, you know, write a little bit, or maybe you want, you know, to find a 24-hour book or something that, that you can do, but just, or, you know, find something just that you can hold, you know, so start tiny. And then from there, it just builds. So,
and the other day we were talking about soothing stones, and this is mine. It's a seashell that's nicely worn and smooth. It's a broken seashell, so it's not a really perfect one, but it's same thing. It's just a soothing stone. So sometimes, you know, I might have it in my pocket, or I'm just kind of walking around, kind of stressed, and there is something about it. It's a soothing shell.
Right. Some people, you know, they call it a worry stone.
Sorry, I just dropped it.
You know, a worry stone. I don't know. I like it, you know, a more positive, you know, name to it.
Or yes.
These little thumb stones, like you can put your thumb in them. But
the same thing with the word stress ball. Like, why do you want to be it to be associated with something negative?
Yeah. So that's my soothing stone. So,
well, there you go. Those are some excellent tips, and I try to keep it to about 20 minutes. So we're going to end here, but do any of you have any questions? You're welcome to put any notes into the chat, and Neely will address them. If anybody has any questions, come on, don't be shy. Hi, Heidi. Haven't seen you in forever. And Mary Beth, I see you a lot. And Melinda, hi, Simone. So do you have any questions? Or what's your morning routine like? What do you do to set yourself for a positive day? Heidi just wrote, you know, that was helpful. I'm glad. I hope things are not too stressful for you, Heidi. I know your job is a little bit different than mine.
What other people do? I mean, really... You know, what are other people's routines, if they have anything?
So Mary Beth, you probably have a morning routine. I know part of yours is in going to work, and you said you always listen to a book on tape. And she's on Goodreads, and she sends me, this girl must read an average of a book a day, I swear. But that's part of her morning routine, I think, right?
Yeah.
You're gonna speak up, Mary Beth, or maybe you can't, you know? Sometimes some of these people are on the phone, and I don't know how chat is on the phone either.
I know, you know, like anything that, you know, the way we eat or the way we exercise, there's no one perfect way. You know, we just kind of have to find what
works. I have to say my quiet time is I am a power napper. I don't get a power nap in every day, but nearly every day, no matter what's going on, because I have a hard time going from, you know, up until 2 o'clock and then make it through the rest of the day. Somehow if I have a power nap, so mine is, I have a chair in my office as well. I lean it back. I actually put on an eye mask because I just need to quiet the world. And I'm not sure if I always go to sleep, but it's that 5 or 10 minutes where I kind of shut down and kind of unwind. And sometimes after I wake up, it feels like a light came on, like a reboot of the body type of thing. And I will sit there because something is going on in my brain, and I will sit with, and usually the most, well, I think brilliant ideas come out of those times where I say, oh, that's a great idea for a blog, and we need to talk about this on the next call, that type of thing. So I have everything, this is Mary Beth, I have everything organized the night before. I'm out of the house in 15 minutes. Wow. My 30-minute ride and walk into work are my centering time.
Yes. And that's something else too. Thank you, Mary Beth. That's, you know, when I do, sometimes I have to be do some, when I, some contract work I do, and I have to be there at like 6 a.m. and I don't have time, I just in the car, because usually it's, you know, it's not a, you know, 2 minute ride. So that's when I have just driving and just taking some deep breaths and centering myself. So yeah, that's, and some people, you know, the night before, you know, might be, it's the best time for somebody, you know, right before they go to bed. I had one woman, one client, and it was, when she got home from work, she made herself a cup of tea and she would, you know, sit down in her comfy chair for a couple minutes. So.
Yeah. Yeah. My journaling is at night.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I feel like I need to get it off my chest, out of my brain, whatever you want to call it, right before I go to bed. And then I can say to myself, it's on paper. There's nothing I can do about it right now. Exactly. It's just one of those things that I say to myself so I can get to sleep. So
exactly. It's like, you know, letting somebody live rent free in your head, you know, it's just like, just get it out.
And in fact, I always say, when people say, he drives me crazy, she drives me crazy, it drives me crazy, whatever it is, right? And I'll say, no, nobody can drive you crazy. You're doing it to yourself, right? Nobody can get inside your head and make you crazy. That's you. It's all you. So it's important, like you said.
It's me, you know, in my head, but getting it out helps me get it out.
That's right. That's right. All right. I'm going to let you all go for today. Hope you have a great weekend. We have some more guests next week. And of course, you have me. So hopefully you'll join me at 1 o'clock. I know that on Wednesday, we have somebody talking about breathing. She has a certain way of that she teaches about breathing that helps to energize your day. So I'm looking forward to hearing about that. And I can't remember who else we've got set up. So I will see you any day, Monday through Friday at 1 o'clock, same station. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.